Bonjour, y'all, and welcome back to Mystara for a dive into one of the oldest dynasties in D&D history, the D'Amberville family. First appearing in Castle Amber, this eccentric clan originated in mythic France before migrating to Glantry, where they gained large amounts of power, made tons of enemies, and a few of those they weren't even related to. While one of the powers of the known world, they are also known for being legion, loony, and often lycanthropic. So who are these mad wizards that are such a major part of Mystara? I'm Mr. Welch, and today we're breaking open the family album. The D'Amberville family, as I mentioned, are not from this world, instead coming through a gate from a plane known as La Terre, better known as Mythic Earth, specifically France. The D'Ambervilles were powerful nobility, but possessed the power of sorcery, which got you burned at the stake in that version of France. The legion of the family was the long-dead Michael D'Amberville, a noble who lacked magic, but encouraged his magic-imbued wife and children to study the forbidden art. When Michael died in combat in some petty war or another, the family realized that without their patriarch, they would fall victim to the anti-magic politics of the land. So using these powerful magics, they opened up a gate to Mystara and began evacuating their vassals to the New World. Another group of nobles from the mythic Scotland tried to evacuate their people, but managed to destroy one of the gates in the process, getting a lot of people from both groups killed in the process. Camille is the matron of the family, the widow of Michael, who was born in 665 in La Terre. She was a doting mother who tried to give her children the best life possible, but was unprepared for her husband's untimely death, or the fact her children care more about personal power than family ties. This has partially shattered her mind, along with the fact that she's several hundred years old. She is generally senile, but still possesses incredible magical powers of prophecy. When she gets a vision, she becomes lucid until the prophecy comes true. Her children treat her with care, but most of them consider her a burden on the family now. Marie Helene is the older sister of Camille, and the widow of Michael's younger brother Marcel. She is an oddity for D'Amberville, being a fighter. Marie Helene and her husband served as the hand of the family, protecting them from outside threats, and using force to convince rivals of the power of the D'Ambervilles. When Etienne announced the journey to Mystara, Marie Helene and Marcel held a rear guard against the king's armies while the rest of the family escaped. In the battle, Marcel was killed while Marie Helene was badly injured. She has never forgiven Etienne for her husband's death, and she is one of the few in the family to be openly critical of him. Despite her open hostility, Etienne does nothing to harm his aunt. The fact she's honest in her dislike of him is something he considers refreshing. Richard is the eldest child of Michael and Camille, and their biggest disappointment. He lacks magic, and while a great warrior, was passed over for head of the household to his younger brother Etienne. He resented this slight, but has come to realize in Glantry those without magic will always be second-class citizens. He is quick-tempered and rather abrupt, as he does not have time for people to waste his. He was cursed with lycanthropy years ago, but has come to master it through sheer force of will. While his curse is no secret among his family, he doesn't mention it to outsiders either. He is still loyal to his family, though his loyalty to Glantry is often a facade. Isidore is Richard's wife, and wooed him before the family came to Mystara. She was incensed when Richard was passed over in favor of his brother, but has learned to work from behind the scenes. She craves power, but is willing to let her husband be the public face. She's also a werewolf, and uses her position to eliminate other lycanthropes that threaten her power. She isn't trusted by the family, but she loves her husband and knows the family's power is the key to her success, and that ensures her loyalty. Etienne is the most famous member of the D'Ambervilles, and definitely the one with the biggest target on his back. He is the patron of the family and the head of the Great School of Magic. His enemies list is longer than his beard, and not that any of them worry him. His death sparked the events of Castle Amber, yet when he was returned to life, the first thing he did was forgive his traitorous family, though he did put a magical gesh on them to prevent something like that from ever happening again. He is one of the most powerful people in Mystara, something that he keeps to himself. He's often several steps ahead of all of his rivals, and usually knows the plots against him. He lets those plots go forward, more out of curiosity than apathy. When the plots fail, and they always fail, he takes great pleasure in questioning the conspirators against him, and then letting them go with the knowledge of how they are alive only because it amuses him. Genevieve de Sephora is not a D'Amberville by marriage, but has been such a loyal ally to them that she's officially considered part of the family. She was originally betrothed to Etienne, but his obsession with magic ruined their relationship. She is the Comtesse of Touraine, one of the family's oldest holdings. She's loyal to her adopted family, but prefers to act behind the scenes. She's at her strongest when she's underestimated. Catherine is Etienne's much-put-upon wife. He married her 40 years before the war in La Terre, and spent little time in her company. He married her on a lark, thinking he needed to settle down. The problem was his activities never let him try that. After she tried to assassinate Etienne in the Castle Amber affair, she was given the position of Ambassador to Thyatis. While she is still married, she remains Etienne's wife out of misguided loyalty. Catherine married up into the D'Amberville family, and she feels that they looked down upon her because of her lower-class family. While she was still nobility, her family had nowhere the power her in-laws had. Because of all the tribulations she has suffered, she's become a humorless woman, going through life out of habit more than motivation. Charles is the third child of Mikhail and Camille, and one of the more eccentric. He was sick most of his childhood, growing up withdrawn and timid. He was highly intelligent, often considered a prodigy by his peers. He doesn't like change, and this is in part that he suffers from overacute sensation. Bright lights, loud noises, strong smells, all of these overwhelm him and can give him panic attacks. He works in Glantry City as a clerk, where he doesn't have to deal with people. Isabel is Charles's wife. She met him when he tried his hand at adventuring, but after he returned home, he reverted back to his withdrawn ways, and what love they had between them shriveled up. Charles can't be bothered to maintain the relationship, and Isabel is tired of the insanity of her family's husband. She has started an affair with a Belcadese noble to make her life interesting. She's open about her infidelity, as her husband can't be bothered, and his family rarely remembers her name anyways. Simon is the fourth son of the D'Amberville matron, and he is the ultimate black sheep of the family. Of all the magic-obsessed D'Ambervilles, Simon found religion. This was no secret to his kin, but the knowledge of this was kept from the outside world as clerics were banished from Glantry on pain of death. Because of the power behind his family name, even those who suspected his secret kept it. It was a lot healthier for his foes to keep their mouths shut rather than disparage the name of a D'Amberville. Simon is a kind and caring man, but during the events in Castle Amber, Etienne's magics drove him insane, and Simon committed truly horrid deeds. While the curse was lifted, Simon remembered all of his misdeeds, and the fact he is capable of pure evil terrifies him. Magdalene is the only daughter of Camille and Mikhail, and she is renowned for getting what she wants. She does this not by being spoiled. She does exactly what she's told to do, and in the process, she does everything that she wants to do as well. This irks other members of her family, but as long as she accomplishes her initial task, there's little they can do to stop her. She has an independent streak about her. Rather than marry into an arranged marriage, she instead explored Mystara, returning just in time to be trapped in Castle Amber. There she was given the curse of lycanthropy and obtained her trademark white streak of hair. Her force of will is enough for her to keep her true alignment, even while changed. André David is Magdalene's betrothed, and a curiosity in Glantry, being a ranger. He is the younger brother of Isidore, though he has grown distant from his sister. He is the huntsman of Nouveau-Aveyron, appointed by Etienne himself. He hunts down monsters and is tasked with keeping the werewolf population low. Magdalene started their relationship, which was unusual as André David was low birth with no arcane abilities. The fact he was a ranger was known to her, but she kept his secret. He discovered his fiancée was a werewolf, one of the creatures that he had killed by the dozen, but she wasn't the monster that he had fought so often. With her help, he hunts down the lycanthropes that pose a threat to others, and she gives him leads on the more dangerous ones. Henri is the youngest sibling, born after the death of his father. He grew up being regaled by the tales of his two oldest brothers, and moved to Mystara with his family at an early age. He adapted quickly to life in Brajeur, the land before it was Glantry. Here, as a wizard, he was given the true power that he deserved. As three of his siblings had no arcane talent, he quickly moved up in the family's power ranking. He was second in talent only to Etienne, so he tried to remove his brother, which backfired badly in Castle Amber. He was returned to life by Etienne, but he's still resentful and tries to conspire against him despite being magically guessed into loyalty. Henri is known for being ill-tempered, vengeful, and cruel. He has no friends, and he won't hesitate to kill anyone who gets in his way. The fact that he's being kept from the head of the household by the growing number of relatives makes him even more spiteful. Carmina de Belcadiz is Henry's paramour and the twin sister of Blanca de Belcadiz, a high-ranking noble in the Elven province. She is spoiled, bored, and petulant. She was trying to play Henri against her fiancé, but discovered that Henri was far more exciting and ran off to live with him. She's not popular with the D'Amberville family, but as long as Henri keeps showering her with gifts, she doesn't care. She doesn't understand that Henri only keeps her around as long as she's useful. Gaston is the oldest son of Marie-Hélène and Marcel. He is an artist first and a wizard second. During his time in Castle Amber, he was stricken with lunacy and amnesia, and he still has the urge to howl at the moon even years after the experience. He is a kind-hearted man, but can lose himself in his current muse. Once he has an eye for a subject, he has a habit of forgetting everything else until he has captured the images on canvas. While he is a noble with a title, he doesn't care about actually ruling. His one and only passion is his art. Guillaume is Gaston's younger brother, and he is everything that his brother isn't. With his wife, Jeanette, they are the cultural censors of Nouveau-Aveyron, the ones that hunt down and exterminate clerics. Guillaume is forceful and driven. He loves his job as much as he hates clerics. During the 40 Years' War against the Flames, he would spare any clerics that would help the D'Ambervilles against their foes. But once the war was over, he turned on the clerics that he'd given amnesty to. Though built like a warrior, he is a talented and powerful wizard, and he's happy for people to mistake him for a simple thug. Jeanette is Guillaume's wife, a flame of a once-powerful family. Her family fell on hard times, and during the war, she supported the D'Ambervilles in the war against her own people. She is as fanatical as her husband and takes delight in executing clerics herself. The rest of the family sees her as a tool, but one that serves their interests well. Jean-Louis is the oldest of Etienne, and while lacking his parents' magical talents, he did inherit his father's arrogance and love of antagonism. It is said his tongue is far more dangerous than his blade, which says something considering his fighting abilities. He is utterly loyal to his father, despite the fact being a fighter makes him a second-class citizen in his own family. If he has a weakness, it's his love of boxing. He's one of the biggest organizers of the sports in Glantry, as well as neighboring Derrickin. He organizes the matches out of love for the sport. He's already powerful and wealthy. He just enjoys watching people hit each other. He created a small scandal by marrying an Alfheim elf, though since he isn't a wizard, it was quickly forgotten about as he's beneath the notice of his relatives. Tariana is the wife of Jean-Louis. She is a member of Clan Chosum of Alfheim. Her father was human, but she appears to be an elf like her mother. She's a major continuity error, as according to the sources, she appears to be married to Jean-Louis when she was 19, which in elf terms is jailbait. This is caused by a switch between Beckmi and 2nd edition, so just add a zero to that age and remove her braces and pigtails, and everything's fine. Besides, her husband's 194, so that's also a lot less creepy. She is a confident adventurer while in her own element, but in social affairs she prefers to defer to her husband. Her biggest secret is that she's a cleric of terror, which would be a death sentence in Glantry. This is a tightly held secret, not to save her, but because her husband would massacre entire towns to keep her safe. Claude is the younger of Etienne's sons, and he was the white sheep of the family. He became a paladin both out of a calling for justice and to annoy his family. During his time in Castle Amber, he was cursed to have the head of a collie, which earned him the loyalty of a pack of lupin that served as his bodyguards. After his escape from the castle, he went crusading through Boldavia to fight vampires, where he was captured and turned into one against his will. Through his devotion, he has kept his paladin powers, and while he can't directly strike against his vampiric masters, he does his best to sabotage their plans through other means. He can't go to his family for help, partially because he's controlled by his master, and also because paladins don't live very long in Glantry. Finding a cure for him gets the party a very powerful and connected ally. Young Mikael is the son of Guillaume and Jeannette, and a disgrace to his family, as his chosen profession is that of bard. So the profession of bard fit him well. He is overwhelmed by the personalities in his family. He's almost cowed by the harsh life his parents thrust upon him. When he's not performing, he's timid and shy, averse to danger and risk. He's looking to get out from under his parents' thumbs, and when that day comes, there will be a reckoning. Monique is Richard and Isidore's firstborn, one of the first D'Ambervilles born after the family escaped from Castle Amber. Monique is Richard and Isidore's firstborn, one of the first D'Ambervilles born after the family escaped from Castle Amber. She is a wizard of great potential, and has been taken under the wing of her uncle Etienne for accelerated learning. She's not a werewolf like her parents, though she often becomes manic during a full moon. She is considered the pride of the family, as she is not a disappointment like many of her cousins. She is being groomed to be the future head of the D'Amberville family, meaning she has made an enemy of her uncle Henri without even knowing it. Georges is Monique's younger brother, and everything she isn't. He can't cast magic, he's terrible at fighting, and the only thing he's good at is dodging blame. He kisses up to whoever will tolerate his presence. He will sell any family secret if the price is right. Because of this, most of his family ignores him, except for his uncle Henri, which pays handsomely for those secrets. Those are the direct members of the D'Amberville family. With the events of Castle Amber, it makes it difficult to keep track of actual ages, as many of them spent centuries locked in time. The D'Ambervilles have an unnaturally long life as it is. But when they are talked about in the various books, it becomes hard to keep track of them. They're a large family. I didn't even talk about the dozens of minor nobles and assistants they had, as this video was starting to run long. But if you need a villain, an ally, or just somebody strange for the party to encounter, you can't go wrong with the D'Ambervilles. Next week is a look at one of the biggest villains in Mystara, Sin the Night Dragon, or what happens when you drop every other storyline to concentrate on a new idea. Until then, vive la différence!